Hello everyone. Today we have with us Vivek sir. So please, with the NEET exam coming up, please tell us what are some of the tips that every aspirant should know to crack the NEET exam.
Correct. There are a lot of entrance exams in India, and NEET is also one of them for medical entrance. Now in NEET, there are four sessions. Two from biology, basically botany and zoology, they treat it separately.
Okay.
Physics and chemistry. But unlike CAT, which we all know, where you also need to clear sectional cutoffs, there is nothing such rule in NEET. So they calculate your score, or they see your score from 720, which is maximum marks of NEET, 180 questions, 4 marks, 45 questions from each section. So what generally happens, most of the toppers who are able to crack government seat in NEET are the people who score heavy in biology.
Okay.
Because that is something which is memory based.
Mm-hmm.
So you can quickly solve the questions, and you don't have to solve anything unlike a physics or a chemistry thing. So if you look at the past trends, when somebody scores 600, 650 to crack government seat, you will see mostly they are scoring 320, 330 in biology.
Mm-hmm.
Which means tip number one, you have to be good in biology.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You cannot leave biology as a main thing. But secondly, on the same topic, it actually happens, you know, as a student, it used to happen with me also, that there is a particular topic which you are not able to do.
Hmm.
Maybe in physics, optics you are not able to understand, or rotational motion is just not coming to you. Or in chemistry, a particular thing is not you are able to grasp. So because there are no sectional cutoffs, I always advise students to leave that particular topic. Because by leaving a particular topic, you can actually concentrate on other 100 topics comfortably.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it happens as a student that there are one or two topics which you are not able to understand, and you tend to waste your time again and again on those topics. You can leave them because you are not supposed to score 720 marks.
Yes.
You are not supposed to score sectional cutoffs.
Mm-hmm.
I have actually seen people, as I just said, biology 330, chemistry about 160 out of 180,
okay,
and 50 marks in physics, and still you are getting the government college seat.
Mm-hmm.
So it is possible.
Hmm.
So it is not that unless until you also score 150 in all the four sections,
mm-hmm,
which we are habitual because of CAT and everything else. So do not approach accordingly. Approach the exam in such a manner that you can leave a certain topic.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, it's a multiple choice paper,
yes,
question paper, right? Tip number two, which is again very famous tip, that sometimes you don't know the right answer, but you know that these two answers cannot be there.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to make a choice of the rest of the two options.
Okay.
So you can always eliminate the wrong answers to get the right answer,
yes,
without,
yes,
knowing the right answer. So, you know, use the funda of multiple choice question is,
mm-hmm,
I always say as a tip two. Now tip three, which, you know, when I read other articles and I feel very surprised, because I thought maybe those guys doesn't understand mathematics, which most of the NEET student doesn't know also. But NEET has got four options. One correct, three incorrect. Correct option give you 4 marks. Incorrect options deduct -1 mark. So if you go by the laws of probability,
mm-hmm,
even if you don't know a single clue about the answer, and you just do a random guessing, if you go back to your probability days,
mm-hmm,
the net expected value is positive.
Mm-hmm.
Because for every 4, you are getting -1,
minus
this is -3,
yes, yes,
right? So unlike a 5-choice paper, which I think CAT is 5-choice,
yes, yes.
So in that case, it equalizes.
Mm-hmm.
But in NEET, where there are 4 options, you are in net profit when you do a absolutely random guess.
Mm-hmm.
But when you know that one question or two options are surely not there, then though it is very, very highly profitable guess.
Yes, yes.
Because you are left with 2 options. One is going to be correct, one is going to be incorrect.
Hmm.
Correct gives you 4 marks, but incorrect only takes -1 mark.
Hmm.
So I always tell people, if you don't believe me, though it is mathematically proven, which we just said, you should always do random guesses in MCQ papers.
Mm-hmm.
Especially when the net positive is positive.
Positive.
Unless until you are completely unlucky guy,
mm-hmm,
which you can test actually during your mock and practice,
yes,
test.
Yes.
So take 5 exams, take 10 questions for which you don't have any clue, and you do a random guessing.
Mm-hmm.
And then check after the results come during, mm-hmm, your practice exams, what is the net score you have got in those 10 mm-hmm. or 12 questions.
Yes, yes.
It is possible that you would be plus 2 or plus 3.
Mm-hmm.
Now in a competitive exam like this, even a plus 3 marks can make a difference. Mm-hmm. I do actually random thing. So I said for every 4,
mm-hmm.
every 4 random guesses, you will get 1 correct, 3 incorrect,
mm-hmm.
plus 4, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 3. You are plus 1.
Yes.
So I am saying by putting random 20 questions, you would still be at plus 5 marks,
hmm.
which becomes very important in such a competitive exam.
Yes, yes.
Which also tells us an important part that it's a 3-hour validity question paper.
Hmm.
Validity questions, validity minutes.
Yes.
Other than the toppers, which are brilliant, many students are not even able to read through validity questions.
Mm-hmm.
So neither I tell them to first scan the entire paper and then start attempting, nor I say that you do one by one and attempt it till your last breath. What I always tell all the students, now this is beat any other exam, that you start from question number one.
Hmm.
In the first reading, especially in the case of NEET, because you don't have to solve every question, unlike a quant section or a DA section of CAT or physics, chemistry, maths of IIT, which are all thing. Here, biology is all memory based.
Yes.
So once you will go through the question, either you will know it or you don't know it. So start with the biology section, hopefully, because you have to score good in there. Go through questions quickly.
Hmm.
In the first reading, if you know, put the tick.
Yes.
If you don't know, leave it. So that you are able to at least go through all the entire exam.
Mm-hmm.
Because there would be 20 sitter questions.
Yes, yes.
And there would be 10 tough questions. So again, what I've seen while you are cracking the entrance exam, that not the intelligent, only the intelligent people clear the exam, the smart people clear the exams. And with this smartness, one of the definition is, are you able to identify and attempt all 20 sitter questions? And are you able to identify and leave the 10 tough questions immediately?
Mm-hmm.
Because if you wasted 15-20 minutes on those 10 tough questions,
yes.
then you're out of the race.
Mm-hmm.
So in the actual exam,
yeah.
the real task would be to identify and definitely attempt sitter questions and identify and definitely leave the tough questions.
Tough questions.
So that becomes the tip number 4, that are you able to identify
mm-hmm.
tough questions and leave them?
Mm-hmm.
So that you are able to attempt all the sitter questions.
Mm-hmm.
So as I said, I think the biggest thing is leave the tough couple of sections if you are not able to understand. It is equally important art to leave tough question than to solve sitter questions.
Absolutely.
Make sure that you are able to at least read all the questions in the exam. Do the random guessing is what I say, because you are net profitable, especially in the case of NEET.
Mm-hmm.
You have to score well in biology, and it's a memory based thing which takes lesser time of your in the actual exam.
Yes.
So you have to score well in biology
mm-hmm.
and focus on energies accordingly. So these are the 4-5 tips which I tell to everybody, that it can help you to increase your score.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you for watching, everyone.